crowd is ready. Drum major Jared Liptrap, is your band ready? Pride of Pocahontas, you may take the field for entertainment. Thank you. on your feet and let's play the Warriors.
For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
And as we come back to play, the Warriors lined up to go for it on fourth down, and Hunter Starkey breaks the plane. It's going to be an offsides call here against the Cavaliers. Nice fourth and eight situation. Twins to the right, single split to the left. Shinnaberry in the shotgun. Read option up the gut this time, and a nice tackle made. And it looks like it's going to be short of the sticks.
Noah Brown came up and meet him right in the hole.
Ball carrier was Jacob Jones. Jones, 6'1", 195. It's a nice big body back, but Noah Brown comes in here at 6'3", 210. And the officiating crew takes a look at it. They're going to bring the chains out. Your officiating crew for tonight's contest, your referee is Rudy Paul. Umpire is Jason Davis. Linesman, Jeff Hamrick. Line judge is Carl Dettinger. Back judge is Denver McFoy. And Hank Crum.
Who did you say ran the ball that time there, Coach?
Jacob Jones.
Can't see these numbers very well on these jerseys.
Cavaliers in the traveling white jerseys, navy blue pants, navy helmets. Pocahontas is going to fall short of the first down, so the Cavaliers turn them over on downs. Warriors in their home garnet jersey and pants.
Gold
and
numbers.
The gold helmets, gold numerals.
And then when you come to West, the same way. They got the gold numbers. You can't see it there either. So.
First and 10, Cavaliers, your backfield in this single wing set. Going to be the familiar duo of Chad Ramsey and Noah Brown. And they're waiting for the chains to get set. Brown on the season, 124 carries, 722 yards. 21 carries, 128 yards last week. And they come out throwing on first down. Caden Pack, incomplete.
Nice pass there by Chad Ramsey. Hit Caden right in the hands.
Honestly, I think it's a great call right there.
Exactly.
It's something to loosen up the defense early in the contest right here. Last week, James Monroe really packed it in around the Cavalier offense.
Instead of going on third down every time, he come out on first, and that's a good call.
Snap is back to Brown. Brown up the gut, and Brown's going to carry it out to the 30-yard line. Be a short gain on the play. And it's going to bring up about a third and eight here for the Cavaliers. Once again, Cavaliers without the services of Isaac Brown this week. Pack's going to be your wing back. Holiday is the up back. The ball snapped back to Brown. He gets to Holiday. Pitched out to Ramsey. Ramsey around the right side. Ramsey's going to have enough for a Cavalier first down as he's run out of bounds at the 40-yard line.
He's going to pick up, looks like, 9 on that play. Did a good job up inside to give the fake.
Cavaliers are going to have it first and 10, mark it at their own 39-yard line, ball on the right hash. Snap is back to Brown. Brown fakes the give to Holiday this time. Carries it off the right side, and he's going to have it out across the 40. To the 42-yard line, gain of 3. Bring up a second down and 7. Coming into tonight's game, Ramsey, 114 carries for 607 yards. So Cavaliers with two backs on pace to gain 1,000 yards on the season. Second down and 3. Snap is back to Ramsey. He fakes a reverse. Drops back to Moss.
Yes.
He's got a wide open receiver. He throws it down to Dan Nutter, and it's going to be just out of his reach at the 35-yard line of Pocahontas County.
Nice play there, too.
Nutter came off the right side and crossed the entire field.
A little bit of spin action there, it looked like. That's what we've been talking about all season, to see if Winnie was going to put that spin offense in. And had a guy in motion that time, too. So a little bit different things here tonight.
Now, here's the situation that has posed us a little bit of problems. Cavaliers now with a 3rd and 7. Warriors pack it in defensively. They get the ball in the reverse to Pack, and Pack is going to be corralled for a loss back at the 39-yard line.
Loss of 4 on the play. And like you said, Coach, they were packing it in there on the defensive side of the ball.
Reese Kelly, the right defensive end for the Warriors, initially in there on the stop. 6'2", 215-pound junior.
So West is going to have to punt the ball.
A lot of good size here for the Warriors. Caden Pack stands back at the Cavalier 29-yard line. Snap is back to Pack. Kicks away. End over end. It's going to be fielded at the 28-yard line. Returner is J.D. Sharp, and Sharp is going to bring it back to the 47-yard line of Pocahontas County. A good starting position here for the Warriors. Well, the Cavaliers able to turn the Warriors over on their first possession, turn them over on downs. Greenbrier West unable to convert on third down, punts it away. So the Warriors here with their second possession of the night. They're going to have a wide split to the left, single split to the right. They've almost got a pistol formation in the backfield with a sniffer to the right side. And play action. Looking downfield, Shinneberry's going to run off the right side, and Shinneberry's going to be wrapped up and stopped at the 49-yard line by John Parks. John did a nice job staying home right there. Great job by the secondary that time. Shinneberry had nowhere to go with the football. And Shinneberry, he's a load, Coach. 6'3", exactly. 210 pounds. He's a formidable runner.
And he's looking to throw the ball, too, so.
Second down and 8 here for the Warriors. Splits to both sides. Pistol to the right. Shinneberry takes the shotgun snap. Gives the ball on the read to Keaton Baldwin, and Baldwin carries across the 50 down and across the 45. He stopped at the 46-yard line. The 44-yard line, and it's going to bring up now a short 3rd down and 1.
Pick up a 7 there on that play for Baldwin.
Read option, Coach, there's puts a lot of pressure on the defense.
And I wonder what they put the up guy back in the backfield for, and he's just a lead blocker, more or less.
Twins to the left, the sniffer to the left.
Got a flag come out.
They give the ball to Baldwin. Baldwin carries across for the first down. It's going to be stopped at the 36-yard line, but flag lays back here at the 44-yard line. Discussion here by the officiating crew. Flag was dropped on the near side over here at the Cavalier, in front of the Cavalier bench. I think they're trying to find the spot with which they want to enforce.
It's a motion penalty. So it didn't matter where so it didn't matter where the ball was.
You decline
was.
The penalty. Yep. That's where they're going to have the football. If you take the penalty, we're going to
work it back.
Back them up. So now it'll be a 3rd down and 6. Just across the 50-yard line for the Warriors. Something that you see popularized a lot in college football now. Warriors look to the sideline. Everybody's got a wristband. They get their play call. Really no huddle, so to speak. They got a slot to the right. Shinneberry in the shotgun. He's going to carry it
right up
the gut.
Middle.
And he's going to be down across the 40. Wow. They're going to give him the 37-yard line.
13
and he's
going to
have enough for for a Warrior first down.
13-yard pickup. It hit us right up. I don't know really what to call that kind of set they had right there, but they had two backs behind the guards, and he just went right behind them. I mean, that's all he did.
Slot to the right, single split to the left. Basically have two sniffers set to the left side. Snap back to Shinnerberry, fakes up the middle. He's looking to throw. He throws it deep down the left sideline, and ball is going to be caught out of bounds. Let's see where they mark it. It's going to be about at the 4-yard line. Friday night for Chad last week, 14 carries for 25 yards, and This is easily his lowest output the 2018 season. First and 10, Cavaliers. Snap is back to Brown. Brown carries it off the right side. And Brown.
They go, may give it up to the 19. Is it the 16 or the 19? 16.
About maybe.
I can't tell. That's the 19, isn't it?
No, he's back. Back about the 18-yard line.
Gain of 3 on the play.
Second down and 7 here for the Cavaliers. Ramsey and Brown in the backfield. Snap back to Ramsey. Ramsey follows Brown off the right side.
Oh, somebody shot through there.
And he is tripped up.
Yep.
And that was Baldwin on the stop for the Warriors.
There'll be no gain on the play there. Oh, that's Kate.
Packs just coming into the game.
So it had to be Chad.
2 minutes to go here in the first quarter. No score between the Warriors and the Cavaliers. Snap is back to Ramsey. Ramsey rolls, spins, looks to throw, and he's going to be flushed out of the pocket. He's going to be wrapped up and sacked back at the 13-yard line.
Loss of 8 on that play.
You got Nutter out here deep, standing about the 40-yard line, but that case right there, got to get rid of the football. Not eat that sack. Loss of 6 on the play. Pack stands back at the Cavalier 5-yard line to punt it away. Punt's going to be filled at the 46-yard line by Sharp. Sharp starts right, stops, cuts back to the left. And he's going to have it down inside the 35-yard line.
Giving
the Pocahontas
good,
County
good,
is starting to win the battlefield position here. Their average starting position has moved across the 50 and into Cavalier territory. 1:09 to go here, first quarter, no score between Pocahontas County and Greenbrier West.
Started at the West 36 the first time, their own 47 the second series, and they're starting at their West 31 this series.
Slot to the right, man in motion, we'll run the jet sweep, and it's Sharp. Sharp had to cut it back up into the teeth of the defense. 2 yard gain on the play, second down, and we'll give him 3. It'll be second down and 7.
And all that was a little jet sweep coming from left to right.
Twins are going to be the right, single split to the left. Shinnerberry with the give this time to Jones, and Jones off the left side carries it down to the 24-yard line.
We'll give him 4 on that carry.
And the Warriors looking to the sideline. There's about 10 seconds left here in the first quarter.
Jones.
Unless they're going to get up here and get a play.
6'1", 195. Still a big back.
And Pocahontas County is going to be satisfied to let the time run out on the first quarter. No score here between Pocahontas County and Greenbrier West.
At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be smart and be healthy. Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness offers free pre-diabetic testing and general diabetic counseling. We will provide you with a free diabetic testing machine along with a monthly supply of testing strips at no charge. Stop in today or call Mandy or Aaron at Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, 645-1890, extension 171, and ask about our Diabetic Care Club. At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be healthy.
Third down and 4, man in motion is Sharp, And they fake the give to Sharp Chenaberry up the gut. And he's going to be wrapped up momentarily by Colton Dorsey. Able to break that tackle.
Had to have a hold there somewhere. Guy had a hold of Colton Dorsey. And he just reached out and grabbed Chenaberry by the pads. And he's still getting 2 yards on the play.
Ball's going to be shy of the 21-yard line. It's going to be fourth and a little less than a yard to go here for the Warriors. Chenaberry and Jones in the backfield. This time, Chenaberry goes up under center. You got to watch for a sneak there. Nope, they turn, pitch the ball to Jones right side, and Jones is going to carry it down across the 20. He'll have enough for a Warrior first down. Anytime you see that offense do something out of character like that, Chenaberry comes up under center, you got to think maybe a sneak. So the Warriors convert there on fourth down. And they're in the red zone here once again. First and 10. Man in motion is Sharp. Chenaberry lets him clear, gives the ball to Jones at the middle, and Jones is going to be hit by Starkey.
Starkey in the middle.
Starkey, nice penetration, nice stop. It'll give him a yard on the play. Be second down and 9. Starkey, 5'7", 260 pounds, and he is a fire hydrant.
And he's quick. He's quick because he plays the linebacker for us in middle school, so he's quick.
Twins right, Chenaberry takes the snap.
Ball on the ground.
Loses the handle, and he has to cover it up back at the 20-yard line.
I think him and Jones kind of run together there, knock the ball out.
Well, they were running that read. Right there, and the ball right there at the mesh point. Jones raked it out of the hands of Chenaberry. It'll be third and long. The last time the Warriors were in this position, Starkey jumped off sides. It'll be third down and 11. Chenaberry takes the snap, drops straight back. He's looking to throw a screen, and he's got it set up. Jones goes up to get it. One defender missed. That was Brown. Another man gets a hand on Jones, and Jones is driving forward, and he's going to be down inside the 5-yard line and stopped at the 2-yard line.
17-yard pass there.
Boy, as a defensive lineman, you've got to feel that.
Yep.
Everybody broke clear that entire left side of the 4-yard line set up out on the left side, and Jones just floated out there behind him. Several Cavaliers in position right there, but unable to make the tackle. First and goal now for the Warriors. Chenaberry takes a snap. He's going to run it right up the gut, and he runs right into the hands of Noah Brown.
Brown.
Along with Zach McClung, Caden Pack.
No gain on the play.
You know, we've already pointed out Chenaberry 6'3", 210, but Noah Brown 6'3", 210 as well. Strength on strength. Second and goal here for the Warriors. Connor sprints out to the right side. Chenaberry in the shotgun. Takes a snap. Give up the middle. Looks like they give it to Connor, and Connor's going to be stopped at the goal line. Cavaliers pulling him back. That's Starkey in on a stop along with McCutcheon. So Connor was
like he got
unable to get in, but he is...
He's right at the goal line.
Yeah, the Warriors are on the doorstep here.
Bring up third down and short.
Third and goal, and they are less than a football length away. I'd be very careful if Chenaberry got under center right
here.
Yeah,
I would too.
And he is locking up under center. Takes the snap and into the end zone. He's going to have a Warrior touchdown. 7:49 of the second quarter. The Warriors get on the board first.
Come on, defense! Come on, defense!
hold us down. Kick is up, and the kick splits the uprights. 7:49 to go, second quarter. It's Pocahontas County 7, Greenbrier West nothing.
The Bank of Monroe has over 100 years of service demonstrating strength and security in local loan decisions. Fathers feel comfortable securing their financial assets with Bank of Monroe. Daughters love suckers. There's an array of account options to suit your personal needs, including online banking, ATM, and mobile deposits. Young adults endorse the convenience. The Bank of Monroe has convenient locations in Union, Lewisburg, and Fairleigh. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
7:49 to go here, second quarter, and Pocahontas County able to get on the board first. 1 yard, Shinnerberry touchdown run, and Shinnerberry adds the PAT.
Got to have a good return right here.
It appears that Shinnerberry's their do-it-all. He is lined up to kick, back deep for the Cavaliers. Levi Weichel, Chad Ramsey, and Caden Pack. So the approach and the kick, and this is a deep end-over-end kick. It's going to go into the end zone, and that'll be a touchback. Cavaliers will have it first and 10 at their own 20-yard line. And
that's the first kicker we've seen all season kick one clear in the end zone.
That's impressive.
Yes.
At least in single-A football. At the time, nice looking place kicker out there. Snap is back to Ramsey. Ramsey is going to be tackled immediately by Keaton Baldwin, and Baldwin just flew in from his right side linebacker position. Ramsey seen him coming. He kind of braced himself for the hit.
Loss of two on the play.
That's where you need those running backs that really get the high knee churn right there. You could drive out of some of those tackles. Loss of two on the play, second down and 12. Ball's on the right hash. Snap back to Brown. Brown fakes the give, carries it off the right side. A little room to run this time. And he's going to carry it out to the 24-yard line. Third and long seven here for the Cavaliers. For Greenbrier West, Coach, now we're getting to the point we need to start generating some first downs right here. We got to chew up a little bit of clock, and we need to start flipping this field position a little bit if we're not going to.
Yep, you got three first downs in this first half.
Snap back to Ramsey, fakes the give to Brown, passes it, and off the shoulder pads of Colton Kessler at the 29-yard line. Look deep here, Coach.
Yep, I know. I seen it.
Now, Ramsey got rushed and had to get rid of the football. If he'd have had maybe one more second right there, he could probably uncork that one to Pack. And that's how quickly your fortunes can change. Pack's going to stand back at his own 14-yard line. J.D. Sharp back for the Warriors at the 40.
And Pack, he's getting rushed.
He's pressured, and he is going to be slung to the ground back at the 14-yard line. Reese Kelly makes the stop for the Warriors, and Pack felt the pressure and thought about running. That momentary pause right there gave Kelly time to grab a hold of Pack's jersey and toss him to the ground. So the Cavaliers are going to turn it over on downs. 6:30 to go here in the second quarter.
And they're gonna get the ball on West's 14.
So it's just like the field, the average starting position just keeps getting worse.
Way, yeah. Can't continue to do that.
Splits to both sides. Shinnerberry flanked on either side. Takes the snap. Reed, now he's gonna run the option to the right side, and the Cavaliers read it well. Colton Kessler out there.
Loss of one.
And really, it looked like the better play on that might have been the pitch, because really nobody there to defend the pitch man.
And Noah Brown come out of the ball game there.
Second and 11 here for the Warriors. Everybody checks the wristbands. Twins to the right. Shinnaberry still in the shotgun. Takes the snap. Gives the ball to Jones, and Jones slips, and he is going to be tackled for no gain. Actually, move the stick back, so it's going to be a loss of one on the play to bring third down and 12 now for the Warriors. So modest losses right here, but Cavaliers have forced them back 2 yards right here. They've given no indication that they're going to punt the football.
No.
Now, I don't know from this range right here, maybe Shinnaberry lines it up and attempts a field goal. Cavaliers got to get a stop on this down, and Shinnaberry takes a snap right up the gut.
He's going to get five.
Kyle Holiday was in on the stop for the Cavaliers.
And it's like shooting him out of a gun, too.
Well, it really opened up B gap right there for Shinnaberry. Holiday did a pretty nice job covering it up, and the Warriors are going to line it up for a field goal. This will be a 29-yard field goal from the left hash. Snap is back, hold it down. Kick is up, and kick is good. He got it just inside the right upright. 4:23. Well, the clock's still running. Should have stopped at 4:24. But with 4:24 to go in the second quarter, it's Pocahontas County 10, Greenbrier West nothing.
SJ Neathawk Lumber Company has spent three generations helping you with your home solutions. We'd like to thank you for giving us this wonderful opportunity to service you. You are our inspiration, and it's our desire to keep you satisfied with our services and products and helping with your home solutions from start to finish. As we continue to grow, you can find all you need for your home solutions. And thanks again from SJ Neathawk Lumber Company in Lewisburg and Covington.
Gives us a second down and four. Snap back to Brown. Brown fakes the give off the right side, runs in the hands of Jones.
He's going
to gets it out close to the 32-yard line. That will be enough for a Cavalier first down.
It's our fourth first down of the half.
I like how Coach Witt is mixing up the play calling here tonight. I'd like to see our line just give Chad
just a little bit more time
to throw the football. A little bit more time to set up there and be comfortable. First and 10, Cavaliers at their own 32-yard line. Snap is back to Ramsey, and he drops straight back looking to throw. He's got a man down the middle, and it is Pack, and Pack was...
He was starting to clear.
Yeah, he hadn't quite cleared the defender yet.
But again, that's on first down. That gets them guys out of the box there so that they're not 8-9 people in that box.
Second 10 now for the Cavaliers. That's what they really need to be successful on these attempts. Snap is back to Brown. He gives the ball to Holiday. Now to Ramsey. Ramsey looking to throw. Ramsey's going to be wrapped up and sacked back at the 24-yard line.
Loss of 7 on that play.
That's kind of a situation there where it's really hard on Coach Witt as far as the play calling goes. You want to be able to throw the football a little bit here. You want to loosen up the defense. But you've got to give him a little bit of protection right there, because if not, we're going to be behind the sticks all the time. Ramsey drops back to pass. He rolls right, and he's just going to run it out of bounds at the 22-yard line. So it's going to be a loss of two on the play. I guess you can credit Shinnerberry with the sack right there. Ramsey steps out of bounds. He's got to learn to just go ahead and dump that thing one out of bounds right there and save a few yards. This is not an offense that passes the football much, though. So, you know, that's going to be an acquired skill, really. Pack back at his own 11. J.D. Sharp stands at about the 44-yard line of Pocahontas County. Low snap. Pack gets it away. It's a low spiraling kick. Bounces across the 50. And
he looks at it.
Sharp thought about it and ends up letting it go. John Parks downs it at the 50-yard line. So, for the first time in three series, the Cavaliers have 50 yards of breathing room. But the Warriors are going to take it over here with 2:47 to go in the first half and a 10-0 lead.
You got to be wary right here of him throwing a pass.
Twins to the right. Twins to the left. Shinnerberry in the shotgun. Takes the snap, drops straight back, fires it out in the right side to Cody Conner, and Conner carries it back across the 35 to the 34-yard line.
16-yard pass there to Conner.
They'll give him the 33. All Conner did, he was the wide split out here to the left.
Yeah. Their fifth first down of the half, too.
Twins to the right side. Shinnerberry in the shotgun. Pump fakes. Now he's looking deep. He's going to go down the right sideline, and Pack is, that's Nutter. Nutter does a nice job over there. Ball was a little underthrown. Nutter was able to set under it, and he goes up and knocks it down at its highest point.
So the receiver really had to become a defender right there.
That was Jones out there. Jones coming from that inside slot position. He just ran a little wheel route right there. Shinnerberry back in the shotgun. Second down and 10. Takes a snap. Gives the ball to
Noah Brown on that tackle.
Baldwin. And Baldwin carries it down to the 30. Be a gain of 3. Third down and 7 here for the Warriors. And, Coach, I want you to take a look down there in the scoreboard end zone.
Oh, yeah.
BCHS is on fire.
It's on fire.
Third down and 7. Clock down to a minute 37, and the Warriors are going to take a timeout. We'll take one with them.
If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning. I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out a warning. I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land.
For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Joe Jennings, Mike Goddard here with you. Pocahontas County, 12 seconds to go before the half, and it looks like the Warriors are going to set up here for the 25-yard field goal attempt. Ball's going to be spotted on the right hash. Snaps back, holds down, kick is up, and this kick is going to be blocked, and it'll be short. The Cavaliers will take over with 8 seconds to go in the half. So, you know, we'll take a small victory right here. You're going to keep this deficit, this halftime deficit, to 10 points. And honestly, Coach, in the close points. So Cavaliers set up, single wing to the right side, snap is back to Brown, and Brown weaves his way out to the 13-yard line. Be a gain of 5 yards on the play, and that's going to bring us to the halftime break. Your halftime score, Pocahontas County 10, Greenbrier West, nothing.
For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
Welcome to the Pocahontas County High School's 2018 homecoming festivities. Freshman attendance tonight are Sierra Calhoun, Lisa Breezy Katina of Arnvale, and daughter of Timothy Calhoun of White Sulphur Springs, and Hunter Kern, son of Courtney Kern of Dunmore, and Aaron Kern of Davis, West Virginia.
Cody plays football, basketball, and runs track, and is
daughter of Amanda and Sean Clark Barto. Eliza is a member of the Lady Warriors softball team and is active in FFA and the Citizens Club. After graduation, Eliza plans to attend Carver Tech in Charleston to pursue her vet tech degree. And our last team candidate is Kyle Cohenauer, son of Peggy Saul of Barto and Matthew Barto of Armourville. Kyle is a member of the men's soccer, basketball, and track teams. He's also an FFA and one of the state champion forestry team. After graduation, Kyle plans to go straight into the workforce, either cutting timber or continuing to work for Mike Barber doing concrete work. And now, for the moment you've all been waiting for, your 2018 homecoming queen is Eliza Carr. And your 2018 homecoming king, Kyle Cohenauer.
At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be smart and be healthy. Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness offers free pre-diabetic testing and general diabetic counseling. We will provide you with a free diabetic testing machine along with a monthly supply of testing strips at no charge. Stop in today or call Mandy or Aaron at Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, 645-1890, extension 171, and ask about our diabetic care club. At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be healthy.
I'd like to thank our sponsors for tonight's game. Summit Community Bank in Rupert, for one. For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender. We'd also like to thank S.J. Niehock Lumber for also supporting tonight's game. S.J. Niehock Lumber is locally owned for three generations. They've been in business for 71 years. They offer home solutions for interior and exterior projects. Additionally, their farm services and equipment are second to none. Check out niehocklumber.com for additional info and to join their monthly DIY email club. Locations in Lewisburg, Covington, and Roanoke. Additional sponsors for tonight's game, Bank of Monroe. Bank of Monroe has offices in Fairleigh, Lewisburg, and Union. They offer mobile banking, mobile deposits, ATM, and drive-through services, plus local loan decisions and a variety of accounts to suit your needs. Member FDIC, equal housing lender. Solak Builders. Mark Solak is a custom builder in the Greenbrier County area. Also works a little in Allegheny, the northern and eastern parts of Greenbrier County. Anything customized he can do with a hammer, saw, that kind of stuff. Mark Solak is a commentator for us for most of the other games that we call. He wasn't able to make it tonight, but go Cavaliers, Solak Builders. And finally, Fritz's Pharmacy. Fritz's has been a supporter of Greenbrier West Sports for decades. With a location in Raynell, they're super convenient to the Charmco area. Fritz's is a locally owned independent pharmacy. They offer several free services, including mail outs, delivery, and SyncRx. If you are taking medicine regularly, they have custom packaging options to help you remember to take your medications on time and as prescribed. They have an extensive wellness center with focusing on helping people with diabetes thrive. Now, Fritz's Pharmacy accepts almost all insurance plans, including West Virginia PEIA. Check out Facebook/Fritz's Pharmacy or fritzespharmacy.com for additional details. Fritz's Pharmacy, we want to be your pharmacy, with locations in Raynell, Roncevert, Lewisburg, and Alderson. Thank you to our sponsors for tonight's game. SharpVideoTV.com is bringing this game to you. If you're watching it on Channel 5, remember you can always go to SharpVideoTV.com to watch online anytime. If you're in the eastern end of Greenbrier County, anytime between now and November 2nd, SharpVideoTV.com is giving away $75. All you have to do is stop in Nehawks there in Lewisburg, Fritz's Pharmacy in Lewisburg, or Bank of Monroe there in Fairleigh. Fill out an entry form, put it in a box. We're going to draw a $75 winner at each of the three remaining Greenbrier East home football games, which are October 12th, 19th, and November 2nd. So if you're watching the game before any of those dates, go again to SJ Nehawk in Lewisburg, Fritz's Pharmacy in Lewisburg, and Bank of Monroe. You can register once a day at each of the three locations for the SharpVideoTV.com $75 giveaway. Thanks for watching, and we'll be back to live action in a moment. The Bank of Monroe has over 100 years of service demonstrating strength and security in local loan decisions. Fathers feel comfortable securing their financial assets with Bank of Monroe. Daughters love suckers. There's an array of account options to suit your personal needs, including online banking, ATM, and mobile deposits. Young adults endorse the convenience. The Bank of Monroe has convenient locations in Union, Lewisburg, and Fairleigh. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Joe Jennings, Mike Goddard here with you. We're about a minute from second half action, and sometimes when it rains, it pours. Cavaliers already lost Shane Griffith a few weeks ago to injury, and
Malik Cox to an ankle injury.
And now it looks like if the Cavaliers are going to be without one of their senior leaders, tight end Colton Kessler. Sustained a first half injury, and he will actually not even be on the sideline here in the second half. So we wish Colton well. And, you know, every week, Coach, we find out a little bit more about this Cavalier team as far as how deep maybe they are. Early in the season, I want to say it was after the trail game, in an interview with Coach Witt, he talked about an old coaching axiom that it was always said you lose as many games as you have sophomores playing. The Cavaliers have had a lot of sophomores playing. We lost five games, and I think that game that he was talking about, that particular game, there were six sophomores that finished the game on defense against Midland Trail. So I don't know. It's the first time I'd ever heard that one. But, you know, it seems to be playing out. Cavaliers going to receive the ball here to start the second half. Shinnaberry will be kicking from right to left. Bunch formation there for the Warriors. Now they fan out across the field. Back deep for the Cavaliers. Going to be Ramsey, Weichel, and Pack. And it's a high end-over-end kick that's going to be fielded at about the 6-yard line by Chad Ramsey. Ramsey's going to bring it straight up the gut. Now he bounces outside, and he's got room to run. He's crossed 35 to 40. 45, and he's going to be ran out of bounds at the 48-yard line.
Good field position starting out the second half.
Tackle made by Jesse Bostic. And Chad did a nice job hitting that thing up the gut right there. And he found a little seam there to pop it out. And great starting position here for the Cavaliers. A little momentum to start the second half. So the Cavaliers come out, first and 10. Formation is to the right side. They try to run it back to the left, and I was trying to get a look there. Looks like the Cavaliers have replaced Colton Kessler with Zach McClung at the tight end position.
Pack didn't get back to the line of scrimmage on that counter play.
Yeah, they're going to give him a yard gain.
Did they give him a yard? I can't see across that line, that field.
So Ramsey, heard he might be a little bit gimpy too. He checks out, and looks like Weichel's going to be in the backfield here with Brown. Brown fakes the give to Holiday, gets it to the 50-yard line. He's going to be wrapped up there. bring the play in from the sideline. Ball's shaving the right hash. You're split in, so to speak. On the backside is Dan Nutter. Man in motion is Pack. They run the fake spin. Ramsey has it, and Ramsey's going to take off. Ramsey's at the 50. He's into Warrior territory, down across the 40-yard line, and out of bounds. He'll have enough for a Cavalier first down. They brought Pack back in motion that time, Coach. Kind of faked the jet sweep. A little bit of that spinner action, and Ramsey stopped, looked, nobody to throw to. Saw a little open field on the right side, and he took advantage of it that time. The Cavaliers move the sticks here. They got it first and 10 now at the Warrior 39-yard line. Snap is back to Ramsey. Ramsey's going to follow Brown off the right side. Oh, had that ball out to his side right there. Able to keep his momentum, and he's going to drive it down to the 30-yard line.
Pick up of 9 yards on that play. Yeah, give him 9.
You know, we talked a little bit there at our break about the Cavaliers being down by 8, 10, 12 points. They've made some great second-half adjustments all year long, and they've been able to come back in these football games. Snap is back to Ramsey. Ramsey's going to carry it up the gut, and he squirts through second level, and he gets it all the way down to the 21-yard line. So give him a gain of 10 on the play, and it'll be a Cavalier first down.
Three good runs there by Chad.
Boy, he just found a seam right there, and
he's head down.
He was almost stumbling forward. Best field position of the night here for Greenbrier West. First and 10 at the Warrior 21-yard line. Five-man front for the Warriors. They snap it back to Brown. Brown fakes the give to Holiday, carries it down across the 20. He's going to be down at the 16-yard line.
Looks like he's going to give him a
5-yard gain on the play. Second down and 5.
Moving the ball very well in this first series of the second half.
9 minutes to go here, third quarter. Warriors lead the Cavaliers 10-0, but the Cavaliers are in the Warrior red zone. Second down and 5, snap is back to Ramsey. Ramsey up the gut, and Ramsey down across the 15 to the 13-yard line.
Gain of 2 on that play.
Third down 2 for the Cavaliers. John Parks checks in here for Greenbrier West. Parks will be your wing on the right side. Holiday, the quarterback, or the up back. Snap back to Brown. Brown's going to carry it up the gut, and he just dove forward enough to get it close to the sticks here. They've already moved the down marker over there to a fourth down. Jarrett Lucaball with the stop for Pocahontas County, and official signals first down.
First down.
So the Cavaliers move the sticks again. And man, Coach, I don't know, over the years that you and I have done these games, how many times have we ended up with this situation? Cavaliers have it here, first and 10. This is clearly at the 11. So they can still get the first down if need be. Snap is back to Ramsey, and he's going to, nice Brown block by Noah Brown, but he can't block them all. And there was a wave of Warrior defenders that came through, and the stop was going to be made there by Jacob Jones, but Noah Brown did a nice job of picking up the inside defender right there.
No gain on that play.
Trying to spring Ramsey. Second down and 10 here for the Cavaliers. 7 minutes, 10 seconds to go in the third quarter. Greenbrier West trails it by 10. They've held the ball the entire third quarter to this point. Snap is back to Brown. Brown fakes the give to Holiday, carries it up the gut, and he's going to have it down inside the 10. Looks like he will be stopped about the 8-yard line. A gain of 3. So bring up third down and 7 now for the Cavaliers. Let's say Pocahontas County may have stuffed this inside run on Noah Brown better than anybody that we've seen this season.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Big third down here for the Cavaliers. Man in motion is Pack. They fake the give. Ramsey drops back, looking to throw. Now he's going to roll drive there by Greenbrier West, but you just you come up a little bit empty, and that's kind of been the bugaboo here.
That's a bit. We talked about that inside the 20s.
Right, 20-20. Now, this time we get it inside the 10, but stalls out on us. We don't get any points. Shinnaberry gives the ball to Baldwin. Baldwin carries forward. Be a very short game on the play. Excuse me, that was Jacob Jones carried the football. So gain of one, second down and nine. Now we've got, looks like Warriors scrambling all over to get armbands on. Twins left, single split to the right. Shinnaberry in the shotgun takes a snap, gives the ball up the gut. And when they uncover the pile, looks like Jones again with the carry. Third down and a long, looks like about 6 yards to go here for the Warriors. This would be a big stop here if the Cavaliers could force the Warriors into a punting situation. Shinnaberry takes the snap and he's going to give it to Jones up the gut. Jones squirts through. Off to the right side, he's across the 35, out to the 40-yard line, and he'll have enough for a Pocahontas County first down. Boy, it just looked like he found a seam right there, Coach.
Yeah, 20-yard run there on the, right up the middle.
He couldn't have had much room to run right there.
No.
And when he got second level, he was able to bounce it outside, and he had enough for a Warrior first down. First and 10 Warriors, they're at their own 40-yard line. Sniffer shifts to the left side, tailback to the right side, and the give is going to be...
Nice tackle there.
Gave the ball to Jones, and Jones got it back across the line of scrimmage.
Kate Pack, Levi Weichel on that tackle.
I think Greenbrier West has done a fairly good job of defending this zone read play. Twins to the right, single split to the left. Two men in the backfield with Shinnaberry. They flank him to the left side. Shinnaberry fakes the give, carries it up the middle, and going to gain about 2 yards on the play. It's going to bring up third and eight now for the Warriors.
Now you got to watch his pass play here.
No huddle. All the Warrior players stand about wherever they're going to be set, at least the linemen. Everybody looks to the sideline. They wait for the call. They check their armbands. 10 seconds to go on the play clock.
They take it down to the last second every time.
5 seconds. Warriors are set. Twins to the right.
They can get it off.
The Warriors are going to have to take a timeout here, or it's going to be a delay game. 2:36 to go, third quarter. Pocahontas County 10, Greenbrier West nothing.
SJ Neathawk Lumber Company has spent three generations helping you with your home solutions. We'd like to thank you for giving us this wonderful opportunity to service you. You are our inspiration, and it's our desire to keep you satisfied with our services and products and helping with your home solutions from start to finish. As we continue to grow, you can find all you need for your home solutions. And thanks again from SJ Neathawk Lumber Company in Lewisburg and Covington.
36 to go here, third quarter. Warriors with a 10-0 lead, and they face third down and eight from their own 42-yard line. Twins to either side. Shinnaberry in the shotgun takes a snap, drops straight back, looking to throw. Looks to throw out on the left flat, and he's going to be pressured, and he's going to get the ball away. Now, where did he throw the football? They call it incomplete, but then now the flag comes out, so they're going to be flagged for an intentional grounding. That'll be a loss of down and the yardage. Now the officials are in discussion. An intentional grounding. just called. Nice job. I guess they waited to look at the numbers of the players that were over there, but there was really nobody in that vicinity. Probably the closest receiver number was on the sideline.
So let's go give a fourth down.
It takes it back to the 37, 38 yard line. Now, Shinnerberry a little bit deeper in the shotgun formation. Back deep for the Cavaliers is going to be Caden Pack. He stands about the 28 yard line. Shinnerberry rolls right and kicks it away. It's going to be fielded by Pack. Pack makes the first man miss. He can't make the second. So a short return there for Caden Pack. And the tackle was made by Cody Connor. Cavaliers will have it now, first and 10. And it's going to be back at the 26-yard line. Cavaliers take it over here with 2:21 to go in the third quarter. They trail the Warriors by 10. Looks like McClung will stay at the tight end spot, vacated by Kessler. Snap is back to Brown. They pitch it out to Ramsey now. Ramsey gets a nice block out there.
Yep.
On the edge, who is that, Colton Dorsey?
Dorsey, yep.
Oh, that was Kyle Holiday. Great block there by Kyle.
He's going to pick up, they're going to give me, what?
Say five yards on the play. Second down and five. And you're probably right, four. I can't see
across there. So.
Little wishful thinking. Second down and six now for the Cavaliers. Snap is back to Ramsey. He follows Brown. And wow, that was Jacob Jones that just filled the hole
up, yes,
for the Warriors. You know, I would say on average, you just look across that defensive front there for the Warriors. We've got Colton Workman out there, 6'3", 274. Shinnerberry's out there, the quarterback at the end, 6'3", 210. You've got Dustin Fitzgerald out there, 6'2", 236. They're hard to move. And
yes,
this, you know, we talked about it. Well, everybody didn't get to hear our pregame, but, you know, year in, year out, this is one of the most physical games they play. Reverse is going to be handed to Pack, and Pack is going to be drug down, and I'm going to guess that that is Mr. Baldwin. No.
No.
I was incorrect. Brody Buzzard with the stop.
Loss of three. Loss of four, he said.
I've seen Baldwin make so many stops over there tonight. Fourth and nine now for the Cavaliers. We're down to 35 seconds to go in the third quarter. And Pack, we're going to have an official time while Pack gets his shoe tied. He's going to be standing at about his own 16-yard line. Back deep for the Warriors. It's going to be J.D. Sharp, and he's at his own 42. Low snap. Pack boots it away. It's a wobbler, end over end. And it's going to bounce out of bounds at the Cavalier 46-yard line. And J.D. Sharp was breaking his neck to get over here to the football. That's going to stop the clock with 20 seconds to go in the third quarter.
Again, they're going to take over on the west side of the football field.
When you look here, Greenbrier West has only had two possessions in that third quarter. Pocahontas County had one. They're going to have another one here with about 20 seconds to go, but this shows you how much time the Cavaliers were able to eat off of the clock there on that opening possession to start the second half. Shinnerberry has receivers split to either side. He's flanked on both sides in the backfield. He takes a snap, and he's going to give to Jones, and a nice job there
nice
by
job.
Zach McClung. That's going to be a loss of at least one on the play.
Zach here on the initial tackle with Levi Wankel also.
Loss of one, second down and 11, and that's going to do it as time runs out here in the third quarter. The Warriors lead the Cavaliers 10-0. You're listening to Cavalier Football on Oldies 93.
Who's 40 for us?
Joey Terry.
He's in there at that nose man position now.
Freshman.
Kids we could have used it.
Mm-hmm. Frontier Communications broadcast booth. Start of the fourth quarter here in Pocahontas County. And the Warriors still holding on to that 10-0 halftime lead that they were able to build. And they're going to have the ball second down and 11. They are at the Cavalier 47-yard line. Man in motion is Sharp. And they fake the jet sweep and
Levi White
get
the
ball.
Tackle.
That was to Baldwin, and Levi Weichel was standing there waiting on him. And Mr. Weichel
lost
going to get a tackle for loss. And to bring up third down and 12. And coaches went to commercial there. You taking a look out there. Not only sophomores on the field, we got freshmen out there.
Exactly.
Jerry Terry was
yep.
in there at nose man for the Cavaliers. Warriors haven't went on a long count since that first quarter. Third and 12. Twins to the left, single split to the right. Shinnerberry fakes the give, keeps it off the left side, and he hits the sideline. Tackle's going to be made out there by Ramsey. He gets it down inside the 40-yard line to the 38.
He's going to have a 10-yard gain on that play.
And
it's going to give him a manageable fourth and two. Had him backed up there. Wow.
It'll be a long two, closer to
yep,
3 yards
closer
here.
To three.
But Shinnerberry, as he faked the handoff to Baldwin, Baldwin tripped and fell. We needed Shinnerberry to get tied up there in the backfield. He looks to the sideline, gets the call from head coach Doug Burns. Twins right. Shinnerberry takes the snap, and he gives the ball up the gut to Baldwin, and Baldwin carries down and across the 35-yard line. He's going to have enough for Warrior first down. Baldwin, 6'1", 162 pounds. And he's got a pretty good initial burst.
And they don't run side to side. They run straight up the middle.
Warriors set up here with 5 seconds to go on the play clock. Stiffer slides left to right. Shinnerberry gives the ball to Jones. I think that was Baldwin again. It was. Baldwin down inside the 35 to the 34-yard line. Short gain on the play.
Here's where West does not need to have Pocahontas just drag this thing on and run this time off this clock.
Noah Brown checks out. Second and long. Baldwin resets, left side of Shinnerberry in the backfield. Snap is back. Shinnerberry fires it out to Sharp.
Oh.
And he goes in and out of his hands, and it was almost, could have been intercepted there by the Cavaliers. Kyle Holiday. You really kind of want your receiver out there on those quick outs like that. You want him to work back towards the football just a little bit. Sharp was waiting on it and went through his hands, and he kind of just cupped that thing and lifted it
yep.
and gave Holiday a shot at the interception right there. Third and 9. This is where the Cavaliers have struggled. Shinnerberry takes a snap. He rolls right, and he is throwing deep down the middle and tipped away by Caden Pack. I mean, Pack floated right up in front of the intended receiver. That was Dalton Hedrick.
And that's the way you play free safety back here. You're just floating around, watching the quarterback where he's throwing, and then you're going breaking on the football.
That was just about as textbook as could be. He had his one hand back to the receiver. His front hand tipped the ball away.
Very well done.
Nice job there by Pack. And Shinnerberry stands at his own 45. Pack's going to drop back. Don't want him to drop back any deeper. He's at the 9-yard line. Shinnerberry takes off running to the right, and he's going to try to keep it, and he is going to turn the ball over on downs. Nice stop there by Dan Nutter.
Good job not to leave your position there.
And I'm telling you, Shinnerberry, when he got to the end of the run right there, he put his head and shoulder down, and
Take over to the 36-yard line. 3, Zach McClung. Gain of 1 on the play, makes it 2nd and 9 for the Warriors.
Thank you. number 51, Reese Kelly, and number 34, Jacob Jones. Gain of four makes it second and six for Greenbrier West. Number 31, Chad Ramsey on the carry for Greenbrier West. Tackle made by number 34, Jacob Jones. Gain of about two on the play, makes it third and four.
If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out a warning, I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters all over this land.
For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
backfield. Levi Weichel, and Weichel jogs in behind Brown out across the 40 to the 41-yard line. It'll be a 5-yard gain, and that'll be your final score. Pocahontas County 17, Greenbrier West nothing. Final score here tonight in Pocahontas County, the Warriors defeat the Cavaliers 17 to nothing, and that moves Pocahontas County to 4-3 on the season. The Cavaliers dropped to 1-6. They've lost six straight, and once again, it was another nip and tuck, close battle.
Yep.
You can go all the way back to week number two against Midland Trail, and Cavaliers had that down to a 4-point deficit in the third quarter, and the wheels kind of come off at that point, and it's just kind of been a recurring theme for the Cavaliers. They can keep it close or keep it close enough in the first half to just kind of tantalize you there in the second half. They do make adjustments. They move the football better, but we've kind of said it's been 20-20. The Cavaliers can move the football, and then it kind of stalls out this. Tonight they got it down to about the 9-yard line, and it stalled on them. A great-looking drive, but no points come out of it. And you got to give Coach Doug Burns and this Pocahontas County football team credit. They looked like they had a game plan,
exactly,
and they executed it well. And, you know, if you're a single-A All-State voter, I think you'd have to give some consideration to Dylan Shinneberry, as he's kind of Mr. Do-It-All for him here tonight. Scored the touchdowns, scored the extra points, kicked a field goal. The worst thing you could say about him tonight, he was 1-for-2, but we blocked one of those field goals.
Exactly. So. But let me tell you, he didn't run the ball in the second half. He only ran three times the second half.
And
that was all in this series. So
as much as he ran it really at the important time right
exactly.
there when he needed that first down to just go ahead and chew up some clock. And he added on that last touchdown, which is you know, kind of reminiscent of that last touchdown in the Covington game. It's really a meaningless touchdown at that point, but it'll look good for him in stats. Well, I don't want to take anything from him. Good-looking football player.
Sure,
they got they've got a nice football team. They're big up front, and
they control the time.
They have nice skill possession.
Yeah, he does a good job with controlling the time. He runs the clock down to two or three every time on his series. So. Just done a good job tonight.
So the Cavaliers now are going to have to regroup. Next week will be homecoming in Charmco, and the Cavaliers will welcome old foe Richwood into the fold. And this will be the first time that they've ever faced Richwood this late in the season. It's always either been week one or week two until this year. And got some scheduling changes right there, and Richwood moves back to week number eight. Be interesting to see how Greenbrier West can regroup here. You know, hopefully the injury that put Colt Kessler out tonight is nothing serious, and he's able to come back
definitely.
Next week. He's a big part of this football team. He's kind of the heart and soul, you know, if you want to say that, of this football team. So it's a big loss for him out there.
And you know, Richwood coming up. Richwood doesn't have a very good record, but they play good football. And looks like Pocahontas beat them 43-16. And did they beat Webster County? They beat Webster County in the second game of the season, I believe.
For the wagon wheel, yes.
Exactly. So, and I think that was all through the air with 11 minutes to go in the ball game. They scored 5 touchdown passes to beat Webster County. So it's not going to be an easy test for Greenbrier West with Richwood coming in here next week.
We're going to take another break. When we come back, Coach Jennings is going to have final statistics for us, and we're going to name our McDonald's player of the game for week number 7. Joe Jennings, Mike Goddard here with you. Cavaliers fall to 1-6 on the season, 17-0 loss here tonight at Pocahontas County. Coach Jennings has final statistics for us.
For the Warriors, Baldwin had 15 carries for 45 yards. Shinneberry, 17 carries for 53 yards and 2 touchdowns, 1 of 1 yard and 1 of 9. Jones, 11 carries for 30 yards. Sharp, 1 carry for 2. And Kiner, 1 carry for 2 for a total of 132 yards rushing for Pocahontas. In the passing department, Shinneberry, 3 for 6 for 66 yards. Two of those went to Kiner and 17 to Jones and the rest to Kiner. On the Cavalier side, J. Chad Ramsey, 20 carries for 34 yards. Noah Brown, 11 carries for 33 yards. Noah Pack, 5 carries for minus 12 yards. Total of 55 yards rushing for the Cavaliers. In the passing department, Chad Ramsey was 2 for 7 for 32 yards, and Caden Pack was 0 for 1 with an interception. And Pack had caught both of those passes for 32 yards.
Enough time now to announce our McDonald's player of the game for week number 7. And sometimes when we're looking at a loss right there, it's kind of hard to quantify it. If you look at it statistically, I'm going to go out here tonight and I'm going to go ahead and give this thing to Dan Nutter. Dan Nutter, a senior member of the Cavaliers squad. He's a kid that has worked really hard over his career. He's never been the one that has the big size, the flashy speed or whatever, but he's a hard worker, and he gives the Cavaliers a lot of heart out there at that position. And Dan had a pretty good game here tonight, and just kind of flashed in my mind there the tackle that he had on Shinnerberry over there on that fourth down. Shinnerberry, a good 60, 65 pounds heavier than Nutter. Nutter made the stop right there to turn him over and down. So our player of the game this week is going to be Dan Nutter. That's going to do it for us here tonight in Pocahontas County. Want to wish Tracy Hilton get well wishes.
Yes,
she's our normal board operator. Want to thank Ralph Church in the studio there tonight for Joe Jennings. This is Mike Goddard reminding everybody once again our final score, Pocahontas County 17, Greenbrier West nothing. Watching tonight on Suddenlink Channel 5. Remember, you can also watch on sharpvideotv.com.
For over 130 years, Summit Community Bank has been committed to providing our communities with the best value and convenience, with personalized customer service that goes beyond what's expected. We are proud to serve and support Greenbrier County with a diverse range of exceptional financial products and services, including all your banking and lending needs. Stop by our local branch in Rupert or visit www.mysummit.com to learn more. Summit is a member FDIC and equal housing lender.
At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be smart and be healthy. Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness offers free pre-diabetic testing and general diabetic counseling. We will provide you with a free diabetic testing machine along with a monthly supply of testing strips at no charge. Stop in today or call Mandy or Aaron at Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, 645-1890, extension 171, and ask about our diabetic care club. At Fritz's Pharmacy and Wellness, we want you to be healthy.
SJ Neathawk Lumber Company has spent 3 generations helping you with your home solutions. We'd like to thank you for giving us this wonderful opportunity to service you. You are our inspiration, and it's our desire to keep you satisfied with our services and products and helping with your home solutions from start to finish. As we continue to grow, you can find all you need for your home solutions. And thanks again from SJ Neathawk Lumber Company in Lewisburg and Covington.
If I had a hammer, I'd hammer in the morning, I'd hammer in the evening, all over this land. I'd hammer out danger, I'd hammer out a warning, I'd hammer out love between my brothers and my sisters, all over this land.
The Bank of Monroe has over 100 years of service demonstrating strength and security in local loan decisions. Fathers feel comfortable securing their financial assets with Bank of Monroe. Daughters love suckers. There's an array of account options to suit your personal needs, including online banking, ATM, and mobile deposits. Young adults endorse the convenience. The Bank of Monroe has convenient locations in Union, Lewisburg, and Fairleigh. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.